All right, everybody, welcome to another exciting episode of The Urban Gardener. Let's get growing. All right, so last week I had mentioned that we're going to go through and do a garden walkthrough on Friday, today's episode, but instead we're going to go ahead with the next pepper episode and do a garden walkthrough and go to the community gardens on our next episode. So we'll look forward to doing that instead on Monday's episode. Today we're just going to go ahead and get going with our next step in the peppers. So what we're going to end up doing is taking a moment or two here, and I'm going to kind of show a project that helped me solve an issue that I was dealing with the peppers last year, and then we're going to move on to actually transplanting and potting up the peppers from the six packs. So let's get growing. All right, so last season and the season before, I found myself with the problem of putting and transplanting my peppers from the six packs into the red solo cups that I use to get them to go in before they end up going outside. What I end up doing is taking and putting them out into the front room under some lights, and what I've done is put them on this plywood and just sat them out there underneath of the lights. So as they get transplanted, they'll get put into these cups and then they go underneath of the lights. The problem is that when it comes time to harden these off later on in a few weeks, it's not so easy to take all of these different plants and move them outside and inside on a day-to-day basis on the plywood. So I have found a solution, or thought of a solution, for this season, and I'm gonna take you along the process of how I set that up. We'll return here in a little bit and we'll get ready to transplant some of our peppers into the cups for the next stage of their growth. All right, everyone, this is how we're gonna do this project. I've got a 2-foot by 2-foot piece of plywood here. We're going to take this container, which is 3 inches around, and we're gonna mark 30 spots around, and then we're going to take this drill saw, and we're gonna cut those 30 holes. I've got these yard stakes here. Now, I found these yard stakes were much better than buying the tall pole, which, in cutting it down, it's 1.5 by 1.5 inches, and saved probably about $10 on going with yard stakes, which will work perfectly fine with this project. We're gonna screw those in. And then we've got these casters we're going to attach to this so that we can move it around. All right, let's get started with this project. Can't emphasize it enough when you're doing projects like this: safety first.
Thank you.
All right, everyone. We had a problem with the hole saw yesterday, so I had to go out today and get a new one. So we've got a new hole saw. Let's get this project finished.
So basically what we got here is our plant station cut out with all the holes all finished up. So what we can do now is we can take our cups, put them right in there like so. And we'll get to transplanting our peppers now.
So a couple of episodes before, when we took the trip to Territorial Seeds, I discussed and talked about having a good knowledge of your zone and your last frost date. Now, it's good to know, in particular for a lot of different types of vegetables and whatnot, but that takes a lot of research into each and individual one. I just wanted to mention, I did find this last year on rareseeds.com. I'll put a link to it down below, but it's Clyde's Garden Planner, and it's got a good guide for all sorts of vegetables, from onions, radishes, beets, cauliflower, carrots, your tomatoes, your peppers, and all of that. It has a good guide where basically you just take the red line for your last frost date, you line that up to when it is on the date there, and it basically gives you a guide for each of your vegetables there for like first planting, for some to start your seeds indoors with, and then harvest times, succession planting, that sort of thing. It's a really good guide for a lot of these types of vegetables. It does flip over to fall as well, where you would line up your basic last frost date of the fall. So you line that up, and it gives you a good guide with a lot of these other vegetables as well. This is a good guide, gets you a good idea of certain vegetables to get started, something I find pretty useful right now. So I'd just like to put that out there for you. If you like, check down below and check that guide out. So what we're going to do now is we're going to plant out our jalapeno peppers. I'm not going to take you through all of the peppers that we got over there. I'll take care of all of that, and then we'll get over to the new pepper station. We'll talk about that a little bit. But we'll plant out right now our jalapeno peppers. Kind of wanted to go through with that. You can see already that we utilized these solo cups, and basically there's other videos done by other people who grow peppers too as well, who do the same thing. So you just basically cut a little bit out of the bottom, make a good cut in each of your cups, and create just a nice cut along the edge right there so that the roots can come out of the bottom of the cup. And then you take a second cup and put it right in, and now you're able to feed and water your peppers from the bottom and get them used to that idea, because later on what they'll be doing, moving on from here out into the 5 gallon buckets, self-watering 5 gallon bucket system that'll be showing up coming here too, that they go outside to later on in the season. So just get those roots going down to the bottom, get them used to feeding from the bottom as well. And those roots will try to search down into the next transplant down to find the water source as well. And last year found out it worked pretty well. So we're going to go ahead and basically fill up some of our soil mix. Same soil seed starting mix that we made up in episode 2. So if you'd like to check that out, go check out episode 2 where we make up this mix here. Just make sure there's a nice space for this right down deep into that cup there for the pepper to get into. And we're gonna take peppers right out of here, and as you can see there, it's got a nice root system already going on it. What we're going to do is just kind of really be careful. We're just going to kind of softly flip fluff those up out of there. Just work to pull these apart a little bit and separate them. Being as gentle as you can, just kind of slowly working the soil out around them. And these plants, these peppers will give a little shake, loosen them up. They really kind of can get intertwined with each other. This is the challenge of putting multiple seeds into one cell of your six packs. I just kind of work them and let those root systems kind of come apart. And we got two plants there, two nice little root systems on each of them. So just put this right in there, working those roots down towards the bottom as well. Make sure that it has a nice deep hole in there. And I'm just gonna fill that down, and we're gonna put that pepper down in there as well. So the pepper's down inside of the cup. And basically what I wanted to emphasize here too with the other one here is that peppers can grow a root system up its stalk a little bit there. So not like tomatoes where you bury them right up to the top and they'll grow a really good root system from there, and that's something you can continue to do with them. Peppers at the moment do have the little fine hairs on them that will grow out into roots, and for mine I bury them maybe close to 3/4 of an inch, maybe just right about so. So that's kind of where we're at with this one here. We'll be burying it all the way up to the top. I am going to fill in the soil to where from where it was at the bottom. We've gone up about 1/4 inch of the stalk on that. All right. So that will grow a really nice root system in there. Roots will climb down through to the bottom here and feed from the other cup. That's basically I got. Couple of these sticks here. I did have a little candy. Oh, there it is. Jalapeno. Just stick that right in there. And there's one of our pepper plants going. So like I said, well, I'm not going to take you through all of these and getting these done. I've got a whole bunch more to get planted out. What we have is, I believe 90 spaces for our peppers. So we will be cutting down to what will be the best pepper of each variety that we have. You know, all finished potting up the jalapenos. I just wanted to take a moment to come over here and show you the kind of almost finished. I mean, we still got a lot more of the peppers to get done. Got plenty of work to get that done. So I'm gonna finish that in a moment, but I wanted to show you kind of the setup that we got here now that we got our project we worked on earlier finished, the roller cup holder thing, you know, something. Maybe someone's got a good name for that thing. Give me some suggestions down below. I just wanted to go over with you real quick. I've got the setup where it basically hangs up off of the roof, and I've got it wired in to have these basic brooder lights that you can buy. I've seen them at different places, garden centers. I think I've even saw it at Walmart once. So get these brooder lights. They have a nice ceramic socket, the ones that I have. So I have those set up, and then we attach the large bulbs that you saw earlier. They are a 105 watt equal to 400 watt 65K daylight full spectrum bulb, compact fluorescent bulb that I utilize to give light for the peppers. I have sockets inside the one socket that splits them off into two. So there are two lamps. And you see is there's two lamps there per roller that we set up there. So I want to take you down here real quick, take a look. So we got the lights going there and the peppers that we just worked on. Set up as it's we fill those in with the peppers, and we also have another station right over here as well. I got some crazy little clear cups that we can see some of the root system coming through later as that happens as well. All right, so I'm gonna move on now to finishing up all those peppers, and basically I'm just gonna sign off with you now. I hope that y'all enjoyed the episode that we had for you today. If you liked it, please hit the like button for me. If you have any comments, suggestions, or a name for our roller planter thing, please hit that up down in the comments there. And if you get a chance, hit the subscribe button. Thank you so much for joining me on the episode today of The Urban Gardener. We'll be back again real soon. It's like a brooder lamp. Inside it's got a nice little ceramic light bulb. What do you call that, dang it?